Welcome back. The time to take control of your life and stop the self-sabotaging and undeserving thoughts that are preventing you from having the life you want and deserve. That time is now.
But how do we do it, right? Our next guest is the author of the new book, You Deserve It, The Missing Answer to the Life You Want. He's going to help us. Dr. Josh Wagner, welcome to Great Day.
Hey, thank you for having me.
And congrats on the new book. What made you, what inspired you to kind of write this put it all together for all of us to share?
After years of coaching and mentoring doctors throughout the world, seeing the struggles they had both in practice and outside, and really coming to find the one single ingredient that makes the biggest difference, and that's whether or not you believe you deserve what you're after.
You say we tell ourselves a lot of self-limiting things every day.
So those negative thoughts, the I'm not good enough, fear of missing out, especially when you see social media.
Yes.
Am I doing it right? Their life looks better than mine, and most significantly, you don't believe you deserve having what you're going after in any realm of life.
So how do we start to recognize when we're having those thoughts? Because I feel like there's some obvious negative thoughts that we have, but then there's others that maybe we don't realize are having a negative effect.
Well, it's the clear self-doubt, those, you know, am I good? I'm not good enough. I don't think I deserve this. But let's go into the 4 points of what you can start doing today to make a difference.
Okay.
So the first thing is eliminating social media first thing in the morning. So
think about that. I love that. Right. I love that.
Best analogy I can give. Imagine just consuming raw sugar, spoonfuls, first thing in the morning. You know the devastating effects that would have on your body
right.
the rest of the day. The same thing is happening with social media because it's all the fear of missing out. Their life looks better than mine. I'm not good enough. Mm-hmm. I'm not doing it right from the beginning. So things I do is I put my phone on airplane mode before I go to bed. So when I turn off the alarm in the morning, there's no notifications. And anyone could do that. That's so easy. So your morning is precious. You shouldn't be bombarded with outside stuff. Do not disturb during the day.
Yep.
You can turn off certain notifications, push notifications. You can put the icon, the app, on a not your home screen. So you're not bombarded all throughout the day with oftentimes things that make us feel their life is better than mine. I'm not good enough. I don't deserve this.
Right. It's like a little emotional roller coaster you're going
on. It really is.
And now most people, if they didn't do that, they'd have a lot more time in the morning rather than scrolling through. So what are the things you can replace it with? And it's a focus on feeling gratitude. Now, there's a difference between focusing like on gratitude, like saying affirmations, writing things. But if you're not feeling it, things aren't really changing internally. So feeling gratitude, the easiest way, think about the times in your past, maybe from childhood, like family memories, holidays, vacations, grandparents, accomplishments. And when anyone could do this, you could be in a busy subway, in traffic, you just saw emails that you didn't want to look at. And start cultivating a real feeling of gratitude. Then apply that to what you want and what you're after in life. That's when some magic really starts to happen. So anyone could do that for a couple minutes a day.
That was tip number two, right?
That was number two.
So avoid social media.
Gratitude.
Feel gratitude. What's tip number three?
Tip number three is, this is a big one, because everyone's always talking about what's the next goal you're gonna set?
Right.
What's the, you know, create your vision board, visualize, and it's putting the cart before the horse. The best analogy I say is, imagine trying to create a mansion on top of a swamp. You could have the best architects, equipment, supplies, put all the money in the world towards it, but it's gonna sink. And that is identifying, being aware, where did these undeserving beliefs stem from? So maybe it was 7 years old on the playground and someone said, you're fat, and you never believed you deserved to feel good about your body, be skinny, be the weight you think you should be. Or the last breakup that you thought this was the one, and now you feel I'm not deserving of love. So just being aware, where did this all start?
And real quick before we go, because we're almost out of time, number four.
Number four is contributing it to others. So we all know someone in our life who's struggling, who's stuck financially, telling them they deserve financial freedom, being
we'll
happy.
We'll have to get your book. Yeah. We're almost out of time. We're so sorry. Thank you, doctor, for coming in. Have a great day.
You deserve it.
Yes.